Hey guys, so today we'll make a simple Python program that gives us exact weather data of any city in the world. We will use an OpenWeather API to make this, so let's start. So how exactly are we going to do it? We will use so-called API. So basically an API allows two applications to talk to each other. So we will send requests to the API using an API key, and the API will send the system's response back to the user. So first we will search OpenWeather API and go to their official website. Then you can sign in. If you don't have an account, you can sign up for free. Then we will go to API, then click on API doc of current weather data. Then we can copy the URL under the API call and paste it on another tab. Now we need an API key. Go to your profile and click on API keys. This will be your API key. API key is an identifier to authenticate the user. Basically, it's like a password that determines who is sending the request to the API. So copy the API key and paste it in the URL. Then we need a city name. I'll type in Arizona. And we'll get a messy text. It's actually a JSON data, which looks similar to Python dictionary. Now we can start writing code. So first we'll install request library. So type pip install request. After that's done, we'll import request. Then we need to ask the user for the city name. After that, we need to store the URL that we used previously. And instead of Arizona, we'll put city using a format method. Basically, it replaces the curly braces with city. Then we will send an HTTP request. So type request.get and put our URL in the arguments. This will return our response, so we can store it as response. Now let's see what happens if we print our response. Type in your city and we get nothing. Since the response will be in a JSON format, we will store it in data as response.json. And now if we print the data, we get the exact same thing as we did previously. To visualize it much better, we can use a JSON formatter. And we can see what objects lie under what. So since the temperature is under main, we can print it by typing data main and temperature. And if we run it, we get the temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. If you do however want in Celsius, you can just add ampersand units equals metric to the end of the URL. And now we get the temperature in Celsius. And now we can store the temperature inside a variable. And we can do the same thing for humidity, wind speed, and overall description. And if we print them, we get all the data. Now let's make them all organized and say what they are in front of them. For the description, I'll do description plus description since it's a string. but for the floating values, I'll use the format function. And if we run it, we get the data in a more appealing manner. If you liked today's video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys next time.